Good morning, students. Today's topic is frying. When we talk about frying, frying is the cooking process for food, and we are going to use is from the very old timing period. When we talk about frying, frying is a unit operation which is mainly used to alter the eating quality of food, and it is considered as the preservative effect because due to the presence of high temperature of oil, there will be thermal destruction of microorganism take place, and at the same time there will be reduction of water activity will take place, which is responsible for the inhibition of growth of microorganism. So due to the frying, it helps to improve the shelf life of the product due to the removal of the moisture. Mostly determination of the shelf life is by moisture content after frying. What is the theory behind frying? So when we talk about the frying, basically what happened, due to the high temperature of the oil, there will be water which is present in the food surface that will get vaporized into form of steam, and the outer layer of the food will get dry out. Due to this evaporation, the evaporated moisture get inside the food because there are small capillaries are present. The outer surface or the crust contains porous structures, and there are minute capillaries are present, and the steam travels through those capillaries and get inside your food, and it get cooked the inner food which is present in the outer crust. And due to that one penetration, the outer surface as well as the inner surface of the food get cooked. So there are different parameters which on which the cooking time get depends. That is the what kind of food is it, how much temperature of the oil is there, then what kind of frying you are going to do, either shallow frying or deep frying, then what is the thickness of the food, how much the thicker layer of the food is present over there, and what are the required changes in eating quality you require. So when we go for the frying, it is determined by economic consideration and the requirement of the product. At high temperature, processing time are reduced, whereas when we go for the low temperature, the processing time will be increased. So what will happen when we go for the high temperature of the oil? In that one context, what will happen? There will be changes in the flavor or color, and that will occur due to the changes or deterioration of the or the formation of free fatty acid. Due to there are fatty acids are present over there in oil, and that will change due to the high temperature. The structure of the fatty acids will get changed, and at that time it will be responsible for the change in the viscosity, flavor and color of the oil. And again, this is responsible for the change due to that those all points we have to change oil time to time, and that increases the cost. When we go for the frying, that there are changes is effective way of cooking, good taste, good flavor, rapid preparation. Fat can reach much higher temperature than water at normal atmospheric pressure. Through frying, one can sear or even carbonize the surface of food while caramelizing sugar. There are two methods of frying. One is shallow frying and one is deep frying. In shallow frying, the only the one side surface is getting intact with the oil content, and after that you have to change it again and again. And in deep frying, there will be the whole one food product is present over there within the dipped in the oil, and from all of the directions it is getting interacted with the oil, and that will be change the appearance or color of the food. And in deep frying, there will be uniformity in the color also. there are different kind of equipments are required, and what kind of effect is there. So it is it affects the quality of the oil, it affects the effect of heat is there on the fried food also. Then what kind of changes occur, effect of heat on oil. So when the heat is going to get affected, affecting the oil, in that one context what will happen, there will be oxidation of the oil will occur, and there is formation of different kind of epoxy acids, keto acid, hydroxy acids are present over there, which are responsible for the change in the flavor or odor, as well as change in the color also. When we talk about the volatile decomposition products, there are formation of two kind of product. One is volatile decomposition products and volatile decomposition non-volatile decomposition products. In volatile decomposition products, there is a low molecular weight is present over there and lost in vapor from the fryers. In NVDPs, there is absence of oxygen produces cyclic compounds and high molecular weight polymers forms, which increase the viscosity of the oil. Then oxidation of fat soluble vitamin is the oil result in the loss of nutritional values, and again there is loss in the flavor and color. Then effect of heat on fried foods. What type of oil is present over there for cooking? What is the age or thermal history of the oil? Then transfacial tension is there, temperature and time, how it is affecting the cooking. Then size, moisture content and surface characteristics of the food, and post-frying treatments. All of these factors together with any pre-treatment such as blanching or partially drying also influence the amount of oil entrained within the food. And due to the excess fat consumption, it adversely affect the health also. The texture of fried food is produced by changing to protein, fats and polymeric carbohydrate, which are similar to those produced by baking. Changes to protein quality occur as a result of Maillard reaction with amino acid in the crust. So there are different kind of changes occur, and of course when we go for the deep frying, it is responsible for the there is less nutritional loss will be take place. Otherwise, when we go for the shallow frying, because it being in the contact of the heat for a long duration, so the losses will be very high. Thank you.